Snowmaking seems simple. Combine water and air and voila, you've got snow. But the logistics and especially the economics are very complex and require six separate elements to come together perfectly. Let's head back to the office and take a closer look. While the physical challenge of snowmaking is going on outside, the economics and logistics are the focus here within the office. Here are the six things that matter. First is access to water. Water comes from ponds, rivers, and streams. Now in the east, water is plentiful, and a place like Sunday River, Maine has almost an unlimited supply from the Sunday River. On the other hand, most western resorts must contend with water rights and minimum stream flows. A basin's high elevation guarantees cold air, but keeping the Snake River running means shutting off snowmaking earlier in the season. Second is pumping capacity. A large water supply doesn't matter unless resorts can push this uphill to their snow guns. This is usually measured in gallons per minute, and Killington is a leader with the ability to move 12,000 gallons per minute. Down the road at Stratton, Vermont, they can pump 11,000 gallons per minute, and not to be outdone is Beaver Creek, Colorado, who can push 10,000 gallons uphill every 60 seconds. And to put this in perspective, that's about the same amount of water a family uses in showers every year. Third is cold temperatures. This generally favors resorts that are inland, away from oceans, because large bodies of water tend to keep the temperature a little warmer. Now, snowmaking starts when the wet bulb temperature, which is a measure of the dry bulb temperature and humidity, falls below 28 degrees. But it's not just about how cold it gets. It's about how cold it gets for how long. Although temperatures at one East Coast resort during the 2011-2012 season were about average, the length of time the temperature stayed below 28 degrees wet bulb was about 40% less than average. Having cold temperatures for a short amount of time is not good for snowmaking. We're looking for sustained cold temperatures. Fourth is the need to make snow. Some areas see plenty of natural snow, like the Pacific Northwest, where Mount Baker once recorded over 1,100 inches in a single season. Other areas see far less natural snow, like locations in Virginia that rely almost exclusively on snowmaking to open up their slopes. The need to make snow can come in different forms, however, as Loveland needs snowmaking to be one of the first resorts to open, and Beaver Creek needs snowmaking to prepare a steep and challenging course for World Cup racing in early December. Fifth is automation. The most efficient systems are run by computers which automatically pull in weather data and create the exact mixture of air and water that creates the best snow quality. Now, systems like these are found at Keystone, Sun Valley, and Sunday River, and can save in labor costs up to 30%. This money is saved because the systems can automatically start and stop making snow at the exact moment that weather conditions dictate. And sixth is a big checkbook. Many resorts spend a few million dollars on snowmaking each season, with the biggest cost being labor and electricity. The total cost to cover an acre with 12 inches of snow can vary between about $1,000 and $2,000. And the time it takes to cover that acre can vary between about an efficient hour to over 6 hours. Now, since most resorts make snow for anywhere between 1,000 to 2,000 hours a season, the total price tag for snowmaking over a given year can be upwards of $2 million. Without snowmaking, the ski season would be shorter for some, and others wouldn't have a ski season at all. So the next time you see a snow gun blasting away, take just a second to recognize how much work and analysis is needed to make all this happen. For OnTheSnow.com, I'm meteorologist Joel Gratz.